Some great games.
What's going on, guys? Brian here
of
of Gaming
course,
Center
on the
CX,
PlayStation 4 hard drive.
Commentating,
we'll see. Will we get a launch date?
giving
a
my
launch
reactions
price?
to
to
Sony's E3 press conference.
Away now from the start
It's a
of the
few
press
seconds
conference.
away from the conference,
All the
and we're going
to
be getting
see.
some new reveals
tomorrow,
from Sony.
We'll
We're actually going to get the console.
Right here
We're actually
on
going to finally be able to see what the console is,
Here's
which
the
is going to be
conference.
great.
Enjoy the
Here we
show.
go. I don't want to see your ugly mug, Jeff. There we go. There we are, at the Coliseum in Los Angeles. Come on, Sony. Do not disappoint us. Just a few. Oh, it's starting. I cannot wait to see what the console actually looks like. Oh, so much blue in there. I would kill to be in LA right now for E3, seeing these media briefings from Sony and then being on the show floor at the convention center. Sounds like Daft Punk a little. Or like some dubstep or something. I think that's Destiny. Killzone Red Sun. God. I'm really pumped for the PlayStation 4. It's gonna, from what I saw at that that reveal like 3 or 4 months ago, back in like February, I think it was. It was something else. I loved it. And there's Killzone right there. Watch Dogs. Another beautiful looking game. Project Cars, Last of Us. GTA 5. Oh man. Final Fantasy X HD. I really need to pick up a PlayStation 3. There's a lot of games that I need to play. Ooh, Payday 2! What was the murder I saw? Ooh.
Ladies and gentlemen,
intense.
Please welcome Jack Trent.
They're gonna finally see what this console looks like. Hopefully they show it in the beginning. Like my Xbox reveal, my commentary, I hope to get this up on YouTube right after this. Though it probably won't be likely because Camtasia is gonna take forever to load it.
Man, there's never been a more exciting time to be in the gaming industry. I'm told there are 1 billion gamers worldwide. There's 220 million in the United States alone. And hopefully we've got something for all of you guys tonight. But I always have to start my presentation by reaching out to the people that started lining up on Friday at noon to be a part of this presentation. Yeah.
Damn, why do they line up so freaking early?
The millions of people watching around the world through our stream broadcast, you guys look forward to E3.
Clients are the only like 40 normal people off the streets into the press conference. I forgot about that.
Information that has to be shared. And when you combine that with a next generation platform launch, that's birthday and Christmas all rolled into one. So I want to thank you guys. Your motivation and your enthusiasm has really driven me throughout my entire career, and this entire presentation is for you. So thank you very much.
I hope it's going to be something really good. Get some really good new IPs and games.
It's already been an incredibly exciting year so far. In February, we unveiled the most advanced
gaming system
ever created with PlayStation 4. And since then, momentum and excitement across the industry has grown tremendously. Tonight, we look forward to revisiting why those of us involved in creating this groundbreaking entertainment can't wait to bring it to you. And I know you're all looking forward to hearing more about PlayStation 4, but there are more than 70 million people who want to know what's new on PS3 and PlayStation Vita.
Come on.
Lots of exciting news
to share the PS4.
On Vita as it approaches its second year in the market. And PlayStation 3 lineup is stronger than it's ever been.
Vita needs a price drop,
What's
definitely.
What's equally exciting, however, is transforming the PlayStation ecosystem into a stronger, more vibrant platform that enables people to engage, share, play, and connect on their terms. There's no better example of this movement than PlayStation Vita. Vita is just beginning its life cycle. Just
over
a year since its launch,
though.
We've built a library of more than 125 Vita-dedicated games. And people have access to more than 650 titles when PSP, PS1, and PlayStation Mobile
it really
games
needs
are
more exclusive games,
it's
though,
clear
which
that people love Vita
is something
once they
that
get
sells
the
a console.
In the U.S., Vita owners have, on average, purchased more than 10 games. And Vita customers also reflect the
more
strong
than 10
appetite
games.
For digital downloads, with nearly 60% of all Vita title purchases made through the PlayStation Store. The Vita vision hasn't wavered from delivering rich gameplay that you simply can't find on any other portable device. Vita is about tapping into an incredible pool of games through a system that offers dual analog sticks, high-def graphics, and amazing gameplay to deliver the best pace to play outside the home. The platform will only get stronger in 2013 as the development
Hopefully.
Community, especially indies and smaller
Just
developers,
so you can get more games on the damn system.
More than 85 titles will launch by the end of this year, including Batman Arkham Origins.
Now let's hope that actually keeps to that promise.
Counter-Spy. Destiny of Spirits.
Ooh. It's like a tabletop
Doki
RPG.
Doki Doki Universe. Killzone Mercenary.
Ooh, Killzone. Wait, that's
and
actually...
Tearaway.
That looks nice.
We're also remastering some of your favorite games for Vita. I'm pleased to announce that games like God of War HD 1 and 2...
Oh. The God of War collection.
Final Fantasy X and X-2.
Oh! The remix are going to the Vita, too. Wow.
As well as Flower.
Hmm.
And Dead Nation are coming soon.
Oh, wow.
Finally, I know many of you are as eager to hear what's next for Telltale's critically acclaimed series, The Walking Dead.
Ooh.
It gives me great pleasure. Thank you.
It gives
me great
yes.
pleasure to announce that the new episode, 400 Days, is coming this summer.
Oh, yeah.
We're bringing The Walking Dead to Vita in a major
yeah.
way with a new bundle.
I knew that what 400 Days rumor was true.
Season of the series. Plus 400 days and other bonus content.
Oh, I can't wait.
As you saw in February, Vita will play a more critical role in our ecosystem.
That should be coming through 360 and PS, PC.
PS4 was designed at a system architecture level to connect to Vita. This means Vita gamers not only have access to the current 650 games,
so sometime between this month and August, we're going to get
a library of PS4 games that can be played over Wi-Fi via the remote play feature. We're making Vita the ultimate companion device for PS4. As with all PlayStation platforms, we continue to bring the best media and communication apps to Vita. Skype looks beautiful on the Vita screen, as does Netflix movies and YouTube channels. Of course, we can't talk about incredible gaming and entertainment without highlighting PlayStation 3.
Of course.
As we head towards our seventh holiday season with PS3,
7 years
our commitment
of...
is
Damn.
As strong as ever.
Has it been that long?
We have
long?
A game lineup today that rivals or exceeds any of our previous year's offerings. Let's take a look,
at
what's coming
games.
To PlayStation Nation this year from our Worldwide Studios team, starting Damn. This Friday with Game of the
Jesus
Year candidate,
Christ.
The Last of Us.
comes out this week, though. Surprised they're showing it here.
We won't get another shot at this. I want Joel over.
Not entirely sure why people said there's like a lot of reviewers who said this was the Citizen Kane of gaming. Doesn't look like it would be that good. I mean, it's Naughty Dog, they make pretty good games, but I don't think it's comparable to Citizen Kane.
Normal people would scare me.
I love the Uncharted series. I love what they've done. I'm hoping they make a new Uncharted for PS4. That'd be great. Or is it technically the Uncharted 5 is the Vita version?
Get a move on.
Oh wow. That was weird, just cut off.
Hero and tyrant would soon have their final
showdown.
At stake were not just one boy's fate, but the fate of the whole moon, and the earth, and the sun, and galaxy, and... Well, let's just say he better not mess up.
Ooh. Beautiful looking games. What is this? It's very stylized, though. You're a ghost or something.
What's going on?
Ooh, Beyond Two Souls.
This is Ryan Clayton from the CIA. The agency wants you to join their military school program at Camp Perry. You have to go with them, Jody. Today.
This is a game I can't wait for either.
Move it, recruit! It's not a fucking Sunday stroll!
Why are you shutting the audience? I want to see the gameplay footage.
Take a knee, compose yourself, and go again.
Use your momentum to swing across! That's it, Holmes!
Take cover. Aim. Shoot.
Come on.
Not bad, Jody. Jamal Sheikh Sharif, one of the most dangerous warlords in the country. We have to find Jamal and eliminate him.
She's a girl, but all of a sudden, he's thrown into like a war-torn area.
No direct engagement with the enemy. No backup. You identify and eliminate your target, then activate your GPS beacon so we can extract you.
I'll be back before they even realize what's happened.
Looks nice. It's like a mix of, I guess, Uncharted and Metal Gear somewhat. With a little bit of, I don't know, Heavy Rain mixed in. Ooh. Sends chills down your spine. Oh wait, it's by Quantic Dream, of course it's... It's like, of course, it's like Heavy Rain. Gran Turismo 6. been seeing all these racing games all day from Ubisoft, EA, and Microsoft, and now Sony. I'm getting mighty sick of them. Really getting bored of these. Despite how realistic they get, it's just really annoying watching them. Just want to see what Sony does differently with the racing genre. If anything. Okay, that looks pretty photorealistic. I mean, it's not like Fox Engine, but if you looked at it from afar, you could probably pick up the difference between a real photo and the actual rendered in-game. Looks like Arizona right there. Who knows, it could be. Like the GM Proving Grounds or something that used to be in Mason.
Not too shabby for a platform in its seventh year, huh?
Oh, those were all on the PS3, damn.
And their incredible talent highlighted by The Last of Us. It's created by the amazing team at Naughty Dog. The Last of Us received global reviews that only a handful of titles ever achieved. It's the highest rated game on all platforms spanning 2012 and 2013 to date. Naughty Dog has now created two of the highest rated PS3 games of all time. And of course, we're equally excited by what's coming to PS3.
Let's say all platforms.
This includes a special partnership to bring back one of the most iconic franchises in the world to PlayStation this fall.
I don't care who does it. Batman. I don't care how Arkham Origins. Ooh.
I just want the bat.
Black Mask. Oh, yes. Come on, show us that trailer. Looks pretty much the same as the Rocksteady.
Has a problem. Some freak who thinks he's a hero.
Black Mask.
Luckily, there ain't a problem in the world.
Generic thugs. Oh, can't be oh Bane. Boy. Is he gonna break the bat this time?
One of you walks away with
Deadshot, Deathstroke. Ooh, Deathstroke. I can't wait to see that. That's gonna be great.
Rid of the Batman. Where's Black Mask?
Let me go.
Holy crap. That sounds like a... Daniel Craig Smith plays a good Batman. He sounds like Kevin Conroy. Wow. Boy Baker is the Joker, I think they confirmed in this game. Also known, he's all played Booker DeWitt in Bioshock Infinite. So I guess the Gotham PD is against you in this game. So nobody is your friend, except for some people.
Nice of you to drop in.
Oh. It's no Mark Hamill Joker, but he's got the laugh down. All that matters. Oh, that looks beautiful. I might have to buy Arkham Origins on 3DS just because I don't have Wii U, PS3. Ooh!
We're so excited to reignite our partnership with Warner Brothers.
What are those Batman models?
An exclusive experience for Batman Arkham Origins. As part of the partnership, fans will get content that you'll only find on PlayStation.
Oh no,
including
exclusive
Nightfall
content.
Downloadable content and a 1960s TV show.
Adam West Batman. Oh my god. Oh, shit.
Sadly, I remember it well. Finally, PlayStation and Rockstar share a history, long history of bringing amazing games to fans. I know everyone
they're
going to
show GTA 5.
Grand Theft Auto 5, and I can tell you that the experience will be epic.
Oh, yes.
We're offering our fans
can't
an
wait
exclusive
for that.
GTA 5 bundle for PS3 that will be available on September 17th for $299.
What's in it?
In addition, we've created a GTA 5 branded Pulse Elite headset. Comes with an exclusive GTA soundscape. If gamers want the ultimate
I want that
GTA
bundle.
5 experience, it can only be found on PlayStation 3. Our exclusive bundle and our headset highlights our continued
I want that bundle.
And you can expect more
I need to buy that.
Regarding Grand Theft Auto 5 to be announced in the coming weeks.
If I can get that, I'll be
Just
happy.
Just to reiterate, all of these titles, along with nearly 300 others, will launch before the end of the year.
Awesome.
There's no better way to show the strength
That's good.
Of a platform
Every title
with the upcoming
A lot of the titles they show are going to be launching this year, which is going
to
be great.
Hit after hit.
Hopefully they worked on these long ago.
PlayStation 3 was an epic leap forward
when I saw Diablo on a console.
To dream of a more immersive and innovative
Oh, and Diablo 3 is coming there.
PlayStation
the first one.
4 represents the platform upon which this vision will be built.
Oh, are they going to show
the
it?
A platform that demonstrates everything PlayStation stands for. A relentless focus on the gamer, an inspired community of developers, a powerful set of tools, and the long-standing legacy of PlayStation's commitment to building worlds without boundaries. Please join me in welcoming Andrew House on stage to talk more about PlayStation 4.
Awesome. They got Daft Punk music in here. Bring life back to music. Oh no, am I gonna get I'm not gonna get sued by Sony Music.
It's a thrill to be with you all today. As you've already seen, PlayStation is in a state of rapid evolution.
Just gonna
with the arrival of PlayStation 4.
I'm getting scared because all these copyrighted songs that are in here.
Power. This means new experiences, greater social integration, cloud-based technology, and a
everyone's using cloud-based technology.
Handling the most intricate ideas.
Probably those cloud processors that allow for more processing power.
We know gamers can't wait to see the PS4 product design. It is a design that is sleek and visually impactful wherever
Oh, you
it is
better
placed,
show it.
And that we hope you are proud to own. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm thrilled to introduce
Here we go.
The PlayStation 4.
There we go. Oh, they're gonna... It's still that blurry image. Yeah, give us a closer trailer. Thank you. Ooh. It doesn't look like shit. It reminds me of the PS2 a little bit. Nice. Oh, wow.
The product designer, Sunisa, and... Take a bow. And to the whole PlayStation design, engineering, and development team, thank you for being uncompromising in the pursuit of a revolutionary new console.
It looks very,
and one
very nice.
That is worthy of the PlayStation heritage.
Good job, Sony. Your design looks amazing.
This is a completely new platform and in many ways represents a completely new PlayStation. But what's always been true is that PlayStation is defined by breakthrough content that resonates with gamers of all types. And this philosophy extends to our media services. We strive to ensure that our services are relevant and meaningful. Our strategy for building an incredible entertainment platform on PlayStation Network is unique in that we focus on our fans and curate content that we know they will love.
Good.
And we'll be offering
really
our
good.
Customers even more in the near future. We're now more than ever capitalizing on the full potential of the vast network of Sony divisions and living up to Sony's reputation as one of the biggest and most powerful entertainment brands in the world. It's now my pleasure to introduce and welcome to the stage for the first time, CEO of Sony Entertainment and Chairman and CEO of Sony Pictures Entertainment, Michael Lynton.
He was just going to be appearing on the screen and that's it.
Thank you, Andy. PlayStation gamers are some of the most passionate entertainment fans we've ever seen.
I am not going to make a comment on his voice.
To be with you here today. And with those of you watching live tonight. For our entertainment companies, including Sony Pictures, Sony Music, Sony ATV Music Publishing, PlayStation 4 represents a groundbreaking new platform for amazing entertainment. We are excited about the opportunity to deliver next-generation entertainment that is curated for gamers on PlayStation Network and PlayStation 4. Through services like Music and Video Unlimited, as well as Sony Pictures' own Crackle.
Cool.
Sony Music Entertainment, a leader in the global music business with artists like Daft Punk, Nine Inch Nails, Jack White, is committed to working closely with the PlayStation Network on further development and in
so that's why they used that Daft Punk song
Unlimited.
Before.
As one of the largest production and distribution companies in the world, Sony Pictures has relationships with talent across the industry who are creating today's biggest hits. We've brought them together in recent years to deliver breakthrough movies and television shows. Sony Pictures is the studio that makes shows like Community and, of course, Breaking Bad. And blockbuster movies including Spider-Man, Resident Evil, This Is the End.
Oh, come on. Can't you please just give Spider-Man to Disney? I want Spider-Man and the Avengers.
Later this year, I am happy to announce that Sony Pictures is hard at work on a brand new original programming plan and a unique access to content that will be available exclusively on PlayStation Network and PlayStation 4.
Cool. So I'm guessing that PlayStation Network will mean Vita, PS4, and the PS3. So they're going to be still supporting the PS3. Which is good.
Will be tailored and selected specifically for the type of entertainment gamers want and love. As Andy mentioned, Sony is one of the largest entertainment brands in the world. And is different.
I'm hoping they get some original content on there that's not like on TV or anything.
Network services
or they do like an Uncharted movie or something.
Sony Pictures will do everything in our power to drive the success of PlayStation 4 by delivering new, cutting-edge programming that is developed with gamers in mind.
Please tell me it's not the tester. I hope it's not the tester. Goddamn.
We look forward to sharing.
That was such a failure
of
an online show.
Thank you for having me tonight, and have a great night.
The reason people I think watched the tester was because Eagle Raptor was on there for like a season, and then they kicked him off for a retarded reason.
Thanks, Michael. We're obviously very excited about working with Sony Pictures and the new ways we'll be able to curate exclusive content that will provide yet another reason to be
cool that they're getting exclusive content. I mean, they're working with their partners.
With the launch of PS4, you can expect Sony Entertainment Network, including Music Unlimited and Video Unlimited services, to be better than ever. The Video Unlimited service will be available on day one for PS4, offering the ability to rent and own more than 150,000 of the latest and best movies and TV shows. Music Unlimited will also be available on day one.
All these features day one. Awesome.
Of more than 20 million songs that can be streamed across PlayStation platforms, Android smartphones and tablets.
Come on,
and
let's
iPhones.
Get to the games. I want to see these.
Today, we offer the leading media services on PlayStation,
Crackle,
including
Hulu
Netflix,
Plus,
Amazon Nvidia. Instant Video, and MLB TV.
Ooh, they got Crunchyroll,
too. PS3 is the number one device in the world for streaming Netflix content to the living room. And we're adding new services
really
to our
nice.
Platform. I'm happy to announce that Redbox Instant by Verizon will be available to our US gamers very soon, offering over 7,000 movies on PS3, PS Vita.
More
and
movies, too. Give you more.
Thank you. We're also bringing some of your favorite pay-per-view events to the platform soon. The new Live Events Viewer delivers PlayStation fans the best live, sporting, music, and entertainment events, live or on demand, from partners across the world. Finally, I'm happy to announce that beginning this fall, Flixster will be available on our network, giving PlayStation gamers access to one of the world's most popular apps for discovering, collecting,
and your ultraviolet movies.
All of these network services,
which means you could stream it through the cloud.
Commitment to providing gamers the kinds of music,
I got
movies,
a few of those
shows,
on my Flixster account.
Events, sports,
so that's going to be pretty useful.
That they love. And we're working hard to bring all of these services to PlayStation 4. Of course, at its core, the PS4 is about delivering breakthrough gaming experiences.
Yes.
This is where our passion lies.
A few minutes on TV, that's all more about games. Awesome.
Now I think it's time to take a closer look at what's been in the works in terms of game innovation and new titles.
Let's do this.
To give you a glimpse of the creative work accomplished in the last year, please join me in welcoming the president of Sony Computer Entertainment Worldwide Studios, Shuhei Yoshida.
Shuhei Yoshida. And don't worry about that popping sound, it's just something I was messing with.
Hi everyone!
It's this guy.
I'm so excited to be here. Thank you.
Oh, I can't wait for tomorrow. I just want to see all these commentaries and the...
For the last 5 years... And the,
I want to see gameplay footage of a lot of these games.
...part of development of PS4. Our Worldwide Studios team consists of 14 studios, making it the largest first-party studio network in the world.
Wow.
Key members of this team have participated in designing...
Please show a Metal Gear Solid 5 trailer.
...and testing PS4 to make sure that it will become a platform on which game developers, big or small, can realize their wildest game ideas.
So like indie developers could actually release their stuff on PlayStation 4. That's nice.
Game developers wanted, but also how consumers play and enjoy games these days. We, the gamers, use social media to find out new games and discuss what we like and do not like about games and game platforms. And as you can see, it's like I have a second job as a frontline customer service on Twitter. When people are excited or concerned about anything PlayStation,
they go to him.
It's awesome that we have a direct connection with people who care about games and share their feelings every day. In Worldwide Studios, we have over 30 PS4 titles in development, and 20 of them are planned to release in the first year of the launch of PS4. We are known in the industry to aggressively pursue new IPs, and we will continue this push on PS4. Out of the 20 titles that I just mentioned, 12 of them are brand new IPs.
Ooh, awesome.
It is my great pleasure to introduce a highly imaginative new IP coming exclusive to the PS4.
Let's see this. Oh, come on. There we go. Ooh, the Santa Monica studio. Ready at Dawn Studios. Oh, is this the Suda 51 title that they was working with Santa Monica Studio? I wonder.
It is a new world for us. For all of us. an age of scientific marvels. And yet, underneath the brass and steel,
steampunk London.
The old struggle endures.
I wonder. Yep, it seems like that. Steampunk London.
The wall dividing life from death. It is so thin. Its protectors so few. But for so few. Such terrible strength do we possess.
Look at all those gears. I wonder what this is.
Easy, boys. It's all right, man.
What exactly is this? It's in London.
We have made contact.
Just watch this and see. Is this werewolves in London? Is that Warren Zevon song coming true? Sure as hell looks like a werewolf. The Order. Ooh. That looks...
Thank you.
Looks so good.
We are proud to have Ready at Dawn developing an exclusive title for PS4. As you know, they developed three of the highest quality PSP titles with us and have grown into one of the world's most respected studios.
Yep.
Next, I'd like to share with you the latest updates on the four new titles we announced in February. All teams are making great progress, and right before this conference started, our developers showed off a live playthrough of new, never-seen-before levels of these titles on this stage here.
Ooh.
For those of you watching the live stream now, the playthroughs will be posted on our Facebook and YouTube, and of course on PlayStation.com.
All right.
So please check them out.
Probably check those out after the conference and after this commentary.
And now I want to take a minute and show you some highlights of the exciting new features and elements of these titles.
Let's do this. I want to see these.
Ooh. Let me show you something.
What title was this?
It was a recon mission across the wall. For nothing since.
Oh, it was Killzone.
The missile blows up in our face.
I think it was.
Do what you do best.
Yeah, it was Killzone. It doesn't look like... It looks something... Unless this is... No, this isn't Destiny. Never mind. I don't remember what the game is, actually. God, February was so long ago. Oh, it was Killzone Shadowfall. Thought so. It looked like it. Just wasn't entirely sure, though. Oh. I think this is Project Cars. Project Car or something. The most realistic driving simulator, hopefully. A drive club, that's right. And then Infamous Second Son. Sucker Punch Studios. wonder if Cole is going to be back.
You have any idea how embarrassing it is for me to keep arresting my own brother over and over again?
Maybe you should stop arresting your brother over and over and
you
over again.
You think this is a joke?
No, I
is
don't.
Is this how you want to leave your mark on the world, huh?
Now look, for all we know, we may be able to pass you through their security, you know, because you're not a normal bioterrorist.
Normal bioterrorist?
Seem to be getting the hang of your, new symptoms, right?
Of course, the only downside being that, nope, can't think of anything. This is pretty freaking awesome.
No downsides. Awesome. Oh, God, seeing these games, I really want to get a PS4. But I want to get that GTA 5 PS3 bundle.
You hit the town, maybe swing by the Space Needle, always wanted to see it, and then we're back home to save some lives.
You do realize when we hit the town, there's a fair chance the town's gonna, you know, head back.
Oh, so this is in Seattle. Or, like, at least the government taking over Seattle. Cool. I still wonder if Cole's in this game. Knowing that, that other game that.
Found the goblin hideout.
That looks like a very stylized game. Sort of reminded me of Astro Boy. That's right. Ooh, those games are looking good. Those are games definitely that sell a console.
I'm happy to confirm that Killzone Shadowfall, Drive Club, and Knack will be released at the launch of PS4.
Ooh.
An infamous second son in Q1 2014.
February of 2013.
In the February event, David Cage of Quantic Dream discussed the evolution of human characters in games and how PS4 will allow the game players to feel the emotions of game characters by just looking at their eyes and facial gestures. On PS4, we can introduce a much wider and deeper array of emotions and expressions.
Show something from Kojima.
Generation of games. More subtle and lighter emotions. This will allow us to explore all kinds of storytelling in games, so games of the future can reach a much wider audience than today.
Mm-hmm.
To prove this point, Quantic Dream has developed a 12-minute technical demo to show off that potential. And here, I'm happy to show you a sneak preview of their work.
So it's not going to show the full 12 minutes.
This is all running in real time on PS4.
Ooh.
Let's take a look.
Real time. This footage is...
So long have I waited, shrouded by darkness. I have suppressed my hatred while I waited for the stars to align.
Always love Quantic Dream. Heavy Rain and that new Dawn Page game.
Time to emerge from the shadows. And finally.
Ooh, look at those facial animations. It's that old guy from the media briefing a long time ago that they showed. I didn't look at it properly. You think that guy looks extremely real. It looks so real.
seven seals of the war, and the talismans of Rastadan.
Wow. It's like the rendering of that and the detail. Oh my god. Those candles look like they're real wax. I don't know about the little goblin guy, but the guy in the sorcerer looks extremely real.
Shit! I can never get that last one right.
Fashta Malavi.
It's on the tip of my tongue. I knew it.
That's rendered in engine.
I am so sorry.
No problem. We'll just take it again.
Wow. Dude, totally freaked me out. I scared the crap out of me, man. Excuse me, if I may, I just have a quick word about the script.
About the script?
Yes, as my character is rather complex, I want to make sure I'm conveying all facets of his psychology. So, I ask myself whether this hatred that is consuming him isn't emanating from...
You know what? Don't change a thing. You were great. Okay, everybody, let's take it from where we left off, if you're all ready.
Hey, hey, name's Maurice. How you doing?
David, hi. David Gant.
First time in a video game?
Yes.
Yeah, welcome to hell.
Welcome to
hell. Okay, let's do it again.
Wow. That looked beautiful. I couldn't tell the difference between live action and CGI.
So tomorrow,
it looked
at
nice.
1 p.m., we'll be showcasing the whole demo at the PlayStation booth. So please come and check it out. For those of you who cannot join us at the booth, watch at home on the live stream at PlayStation.com and on YouTube. It's amazing and fun.
Oh, the stream got less HD-ish. It's all blurry now.
Supporting independent and smaller developers who bring a fresh perspective to game development. Oftentimes, we are amazed and totally inspired by the sheer passion and creativity of these smaller teams. Here to share with you some of the exciting games they've got coming to PlayStation is Adam Boyce.
Who? Adam Boyce. Nice person, third party relations.
Shu Yoshida. That man has the most infectious smile. Doing good? Excellent. So you've all seen some impressive blockbusters that are coming to PS4 in the near future.
Damn right.
But as with platforms, cultivating a wide variety of experiences is critical to our DNA.
Let's get some third parties in
back
here.
In February, we had Jonathan Blow on stage with it to see his team's first game, The Witness, coming first on consoles to PS4. Right.
Oh, was that the...
And we absolutely loved scouring the...
From the guy who made Braid.
...and innovative developers. And tonight, I'm thrilled to...
Oh shit!
Introduce
oh.
another incredible and
tonight. Oh come on!
Tonight, I'm thrilled to introduce another incredible team.
Damn it!
Team, which we've wanted to partner with for years. Please join.
Sorry.
Join me in welcome.
Sorry guys, I had to refresh it a bit just because it's stupid.
Fans, our first game, Bastion.
Supergiant Games.
Independence and stick together as a team to do a new game in our voice.
We grew up playing games that transported us to all sorts of amazing places we'll never forget. So with that in mind, it's our pleasure to show you Transistor,
oh,
which will make its console
the creators
on
the
PlayStation
of,
4 early next year. Check it out.
Which Bastion. Transistor. This is a game I want to pick up.
When you speak, I hear
showed it a while ago, I think. New York Comic Con? No, PAX. They showed us at PAX. And it looked beautiful. It looks so different than Bastion was. It just looks like a very beautiful game. I mean, the art style is just amazing. I wonder what they're gonna have here today, though. They're gonna get something good. Like with the indie crowd, I mean. Something we didn't expect, hopefully. Transistor. Can't wait. Ah, 2014. damn it, I want that to come out this year.
Thanks to the Supergiant Games team. For more on Transistor, please stop by our booth. You'll be able to meet the development team and also play the game yourself with hands-on.
Awesome.
Our commitment to independent creators does not stop there. We're developing the world's best indie game portfolio across all PlayStation platforms by offering developers the ability to self-publish their own content.
Good.
Yeah.
You have to get a publisher. It's good for creators.
The recently added indie section of the PlayStation Store enables fans to quickly find the newest and most popular titles. Our vision is crystal clear: to continue to lead the console space as the most open and inclusive platform for developers, while providing gamers with an endless variety of beautiful,
challenging, and fantastic experiences. I don't know, you might have to compete with Nintendo, because they're pretty open with their platform, too.
It's now my great pleasure to introduce a few of the new additions to the PlayStation family. Clay Entertainment.
Don't starve! Ooh!
Their 2D artistry and classic approach to game design were evident in Shank and Mark of the Ninja.
I'd love Don't
Starve.
When
their co-founder Jamie Chang first teased us with this wonderfully...
Oh, come on, stop... Sorry guys, I have to refresh the stupid stream again.
Before breaking out on their own, these founders made the totally awesome retro brawler Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. They're now preparing to unleash Mercenary Kings, a hand-drawn
Mercenary
shooter
Kings.
That... Young Horses.
Octodad.
We sent PlayStation 4 dev kits to the studio comprised of DePaul University grads in Chicago. Within only 4 weeks, they sent us back a playable version of their IGF-nominated game series. Octodad Deadliest Catch will stagger awkwardly onto PlayStation 4. Now, although historically accurate, this game does not contain giant enemy crabs. Switchblade Monkeys. This crew came together when a group of friends across multiple studios around the world broke off to pursue a new creative vision. Secret Ponchos
reminds me
of
the heavy
elements of shooters,
I don't know.
And fighting games.
Maybe it's because he has a minigun with he has a bandolier on. And he's a giant fat guy with a minigun.
Ragtag Studios.
Oh, stop. This is shitty. I'm sorry, guys. This stream keeps fucking up so badly.
This stealth action puzzler brings a lot of great humor to the PlayStation 4 and tasks you with recruiting a zombie army in Ray's quest to find out why he was killed. Red Barrels.
Outlast.
This Montreal team was formed by talented industry veterans to create unforgettable single-player experiences. When I played Outlast at PAX East, it scared the bejesus out of me. It's truly terrifying, a first-person fright fest that you can check out in our booth.
Ooh, shit.
Oddworld Inhabitants.
New and Lauren tasty.
Lanning. Right. Lauren was a fiercely independent game creator in an era when no small studio dared to even ask for creative control. The Oddworld universe
oh
first
my
emerged
God, it's
from
an Oddworld game.
Mine on the PlayStation 1. And here at Sony,
awesome.
We've been massive fans of his unlikely heroes ever since. We're happy to announce that a full remake of the original, called Oddworld New and Tasty, is coming to PS4.
Cool.
17-bit games.
Galaxy.
Anyone who has played Skulls of the Shogun knows this talented team at 17-bit games. A few months ago at the Full Indie Summit in Vancouver, their founder, Jake Kasdahl, snuck us out to his friend's house to demo his new game, Galaxy, a side-scrolling open-world space shooter that I just couldn't stop playing. This is an incredible slate of content from a few of the amazing independent creative teams. We're welcome to the family.
I'm loving these. I mean, you got Don't Starve, Raise of the Dead. Oh, what else? Ponchos, Octodad, Mercenary Kings.
They give us an absolute richness
Secret
and depth
Ponchos,
that can't
that's
be found anywhere else.
This is going to be a great
part,
indie lineup.
Every single one of these games in the stage in front of you will be making their exclusive console debut on PlayStation 4.
Awesome. I'm glad Don't Starve is on there. That's a great game.
Thank you guys so much for being here.
Still wondering why they sent Mojang a PS PlayStation event invitation. Are they showing something?
Of course, PlayStation 4 will also be home to giant blockbuster games. Blizzard Entertainment is bringing Diablo 3 both the PS3
and I forgot PS4. About Diablo coming to
We're
there.
We're proud to announce today Diablo 3 will have, on PS3, will have exclusive items from PlayStation franchises like Drake's Amulet from Uncharted
and Shoulder are Races
inspired by that game company's indie hit Journey. Pretty cool.
Blizzard's making exclusive items
there
now.
There will also be more PlayStation exclusive items from Blizzard in the future. Now, when we revealed the PS4 back in February, we welcomed a very special partner on stage to talk about the future. And they
Blizzard.
Left us wanting just a little
or
bit
Bungie.
More. I'm very honored and proud to share a video message from the brilliant mind of Tetsuya Nomura
oh, Square
from
Enix.
Square Enix.
Ooh.
Square Enix Nomura
said, can't wait. Ooh. Versus 13. Not today. Are they actually going to do Versus 13? Because it's been in development since, like, I don't know, 2006. Holy shit.
Noctis-sama mo hikari ga mieru n desu ne.
Ore ga nani o shitteiru no ka, ore jishin mo shiranai n da.
Oh, wow. It is Versus 13. Took him long enough, Jesus. God, man. What took him so long? Seriously, holy shit.
どうした? 食べないのか?
おいしくないよ.
Can't wait.
料理人が仕事をし...
Jesus Christ. How long it took. I like how the style has improved it so much. It just looks like a beautiful game now. Ooh. Guy looks strangely like Ganondorf. I don't know why. Oh, shit, giant dragon shit. What is a gun blade? Sure is how it works. Maybe it's just a normal blade, who knows? Sort of looks like a gun blade. Finally! What was it? 7 freaking years? Final Fantasy 15. Final Fantasy 13 Versus is now Final Fantasy 15. Lightning Returns. Ooh. Oh! Kingdom Hearts 3? Or is it going to be Kingdom Hearts 1 HD remake? Wow. Oh my god. Final. Whoa! Shit! Oh my god! Oh, good lord! Oh my god, I'm crying. Jeez, it's been so freaking long. Now in development. Oh my god! Shit!
Fantasy 15 and Kingdom Hearts 3 coming to PS4.
Damn, Sony. Sony wins E3. Oh my god.
As one more gift to PlayStation fans, I'm happy to announce that Final Fantasy 14 will be coming exclusively to consoles on PS4 and PS3.
14's just that online game that nobody cares about, though. Assassin's Creed Black Flag.
Now, Ubisoft is no stranger to pushing the boundaries of play.
Kingdom Hearts 3.
And with Assassin's
God.
Creed 4 Black Flag, they've created an entirely new world filled with huge beards, rum drinking, swashbuckling, and skullduggery.
Yeah!
Right. I mean, who doesn't want to play a game as Edward Kenway, a pirate trained by assassins?
Yeah!
Or play as Aveline from Assassin's Creed 3 Liberation on Vita, which will be an exclusive PlayStation experience.
Oh!
Here to play
She's
the
in the same timeline.
Game, sorry, demo of the game. Please welcome producer Arno.
Oh, that's kind of cool. She's from Liberation. She's in the game, which is nice. God, I still can't get over Kingdom Hearts 3. Oh, weird. A little bit of freezing. Thank God it didn't crash my system in any way. Else I would have been pissed. Ooh. Blackbeard?
Maybe he remembers where his rat is hiding. Before my
Edward Teague. Sorry, a little bit of freezing there on my end. I don't know why.
I flushed him out. I'll catch you up, Thatch.
There's no drinking after death, lads.
So this is like Tortuga for everyone. If I'm comparing it to Pirates of the Caribbean, this is where all the pillaging, women loving is. I keep freezing for some reason, I don't get why.
I'll come back for your coin later.
You be seeking adventure with salty old pirates, are ye? Repeated twice. Or repeated.
What was that? You certainly didn't bring some of those sandwiches in tall, Jenkins.
Look sharp.
Damn, we only got like 40 minutes left in this conference.
I'll secure the other side and watch the park. Shoot anything that moves.
Did he screw up on them?
Come on. It's time.
It looks like he brushed them a bit.
Tell me about the beast.
Unless he poisoned them. Oh, he didn't even notice him because he was too freaking drunk.
Have no fear, soldier. This will be the end of it. What about our man?
They've been pressing him hard.
I'm just gonna watch this demo.
But he's not broken yet.
Because it's looking like a pretty good game. Might be a little bit better than Assassin. Ooh, tree climbing again.
Quickly, send the signal.
Get him! Ooh, flint marks, please, please. Double flint marks.
What the devil?
Oh, shit. Wow. This is running on PS4, too. Jesus. Look at those explosions, the fire. Physics, real time explosions. And like music that could fit any Pirates of the Caribbean ride or movie. Sounds amazing. Naval combat, water combat too, which is incredible.
He's a big bastard! Hold the heavy shot, lads! Even the waist!
The cloth, there's a ton of sails. It's looking really beautiful. This freaking game. Oh. Oh, okay. It froze on the stream, on the screen too. It's not the stream. That makes me wonder, I'm like, why is it freezing all the time? That confused me a lot.
We're outnumbered, mate. It's not the first time, Kenway. And it won't be the last. Take no quarter, lads!
Oh, poor Sony, man. Jesus Christ. Ooh. Those technical difficulties. I hate that when that happens. It doesn't really give you the full rundown of the game.
Hello, everyone. I'm Jonathan Morin, the creative director on Watch Dogs. There are countless ways to define next gen.
Ooh, Watch Dogs.
For us, it has to be about new game dynamics. Over the last 4 years, we challenged ourselves to deliver something new.
They got a different trailer from the last one.
So we created an entire city that you can hack at will.
Ooh.
Everything that is connected can become your weapon against your enemies, or can be used to help your friends. In Watch Dogs, you are Aiden Pierce, a modern vigilante whose most powerful weapon is a smartphone. In today's demo, Aiden must save a friend called T-Bone. He broke into an apartment to steal important information, but he tripped an alarm, and fixers are coming his way to kill him. We join Aiden after
this
Chicago
is a game I've been waiting for a long time. Open world, do pretty much anything.
To be able to save
side quests all over the place.
So
and that's something I want to play.
Pierre-Yves Savard was gonna perform.
I'll probably, if I get a Wii U, I'll probably pick it up for that.
And let's
despite
see.
People thinking
since
Wii U is a little bit underpowered.
Play any way you want,
I disagree.
How he will choose to approach the situation. Enjoy the show and thank you very
let's
much.
Let's watch this demo. I'm probably not going to be... It's not going to cease to impress me. He never fails to impress. About their business in this game. He's a vigilante, so he doesn't want them to find him. Still, the city's beautiful, creator. I'm loving it. Awesome, finally get to see a chase without him on being on foot, getting some vehicle job scenes, or vehicle gameplay, I should say. They just go past them.
Yeah, squad. Suspect's gone. Let's get an APB circulated.
Kill it, now.
Hello, I need you to stay on the line.
Hey, why are you doing this?
Oof. You gotta avoid people trying to take you.
T-Bone. Yeah.
Hit this, brother. Prototype ship I ain't never seen. I'm in love.
T-Bone, wrap it up.
Okay. Go, go. You sound cranky. Forget the
this
toys.
This guy's awesome.
You out. Sorry, princess.
Gotta get the T-Bone. That's nice. I'm loving like the different ways you can actually play the game. You can set off certain things to distract enemies. It's interesting ways to do have these mechanics. Are those like citizen vigilantes or something?
Don't move until I say. Go. Stay low.
Telling him where to go.
Yeah, go.
You got it.
You find what we need in there?
Yeah. Default didn't expect us to find this romper room. I got what I needed to track him. Don't you worry. We're getting closer to your sister.
So Aiden has to find his sister?
Yeah, go.
Help!
go.
Jesus.
You can go back across and get into that car he had in the game. Hopefully.
You're good. Go. I owe you, Aiden.
Damn, that guy dead.
All units, this is Squad. We have a possible sighting on Aiden Pierce.
Oh! Somebody's gonna be on like a cell phone or something? A cell phone or a tablet, you can help them out. That's cool. Okay, that is very, very cool. To screw with that helicopter. Very nice. Oh, I'm loving like the tablet integration and the. It's just something that's really freaking cool. Shoot him in the kneecap. You don't want to kill him, you just want to, take a boat. That is awesome. I'm loving what Watch Dogs is doing. Each new gameplay for this day. Keep impressing me each and every single time. This is a game of the year contender right here. It's going to be like Last of Us, Bioshock Infinite. Probably Telltale, Walking Dead Season 2, and Watch Dogs. That's going
to
be amazing.
When Watch Dogs launches, I'm happy to announce that PlayStation owners will receive an additional hour of exclusive gameplay and a special outfit for Aiden Pierce.
Cool.
And Chicago looked pretty great in that last bit with Watch Dogs. And from Chicago all the way back here to L.A., from the Bulls to Lakers, it's not just technology that connects us. Everyone has grown up with a passion for their favorite sports team.
Okay, I'm talking about sports.
The pride of donning your team's first jersey, the cheers in the stadium ricocheting
sports,
off the walls.
Come on.
That broken heart feeling after that overtime loss. Sorry, Kings fans. These are the authentic moments that connect us. That authenticity bleeds into our games. And never before have we had such a powerful platform to express these sports experiences.
What are they going to show?
With that, let's look at what's truly possible on PS4, all running an engine.
Oh, they're going to show the Ignite. Oh, 2K games.
When they told me they had a surprise set up, I didn't think it was going to be like this. I know, right? It's video game James in the flesh.
Wow. Huh,
kind of. I can see the guys at 2K. They ain't messing around on these next-gen graphics. Man, you look sick. Not bad, huh? Soak it in, Playboy. They nailed every single detail. I'm you, but digital. Now, you may be an exact replica. Can you ball like me? Can I ball? That's funny. Somebody wrote a clip.
It really does look like LeBron James. It's nice. I mean, like, they're updating, like, details of players and stuff and how they look. I could see them, like, if they change something on their body, that they could easily update that through like, updates and everything. And it would look really, really good. I'm not a big sports game fan, but these are... Ooh! Bethesda's here with the Elder Scrolls Online.
I think LeBron's going to need some of those next-gen skills in the game against Spurs tomorrow night.
Yeah.
Am I right? When I think of this next publisher,
Bethesda.
I think about the massive impact that their games have had in our gaming culture. I have to admit, I spent over 200 hours.
It'd be cool
dragons,
if they
reveal
something
locks,
big here.
Cheese wheels. Now, for the first
Must
time,
roll
in the
all those
of the
cheese
series,
wheels down the
In
hill.
Addition to adventuring alone, you can experience the mythology of this world alongside all of your friends. Tonight, we're thrilled to announce our new partnership with Bethesda Softworks. And the next epic chapter in their legendary saga.
The Elder Scrolls Online. I don't know where it takes place. Skyrim, Morrowind, or... Is it called Oblivion? Yeah, I think it is called Oblivion, that where Oblivion takes place. Makes sense. It's called Oblivion.
I'm just ranting. Let's just watch the trailer.
A new dawn is upon us. Never have our choices weighed more heavily. To stand alone, or to fight side by side.
Nice.
Against the encroaching forces of oblivion.
To save Tamara. Oh, Tamara. Wow. That's awesome. The Elder Scrolls Online. Awesome. I wonder if Bethesda's got something else under their sleeve too.
We are excited to announce that the Elder Scrolls Online will have a beta that will be exclusively available first on PlayStation 4. Oh,
damn it. Come on.
When we first saw this next universe being created, we couldn't wait to see it come to life on PlayStation. This team brings you one of the most influential fictional worlds that's ever been created. We're extremely
Bungie.
Proud to be able to share this world premiere with our PlayStation fans first.
What is this? Oh my god, is that... What is this? It looks so familiar. Desert landscape. Is this Fallout? Something in the fall. Oh my god. Reminds me of Fallout. I mean, everything screams Fallout to me. Mad Max? Oh, wow. Jeez, they haven't been Mad Max in forever.
Mad Max has influenced the world of entertainment from movies to games. And it's been amazing to watch Warner Brothers Interactive Entertainment and Avalanche Studios bring this vision to life.
I seriously thought it was Fallout at first, the desert landscape and everything.
You have access to the exclusive Road Warrior Survival Kit only on PlayStation.
Oh, so much exclusive PlayStation content.
Please welcome back Jack Trenton.
All this exclusive PlayStation content. Jesus Christ, man. Are they ending the conference now?
Well, that's all he's got. I'm a little worried, but not so bad for a start. Thanks, Adam. It's clear that all of the best development studios in the world are creating amazing games for PlayStation 4. Games such as Call of Duty Ghosts, FIFA, and Madden. Globally, there are more than 140
those couple
games
cheers, God.
For PS4 across our own worldwide studios and our third-party partners, including over 100 that will be available within the first year.
I can't wait.
Nearly 40 of these titles feature experiences that are exclusive to PlayStation. In addition to creating an amazing library of new titles on PlayStation 4, we're equally focused on delivering what gamers want most without imposing restrictions or devaluing their PS4 purchases.
Yes!
For instance, PlayStation 4
won't impose any new restrictions.
Yeah! That's what you're talking about. That's it. Yes! Take that, Microsoft. I love you, Sony. You're like, screw you, Microsoft. We support used games. That's how you do it. That's how you freaking do it. Yeah.
Guess that's a good thing. We believe in the model that people embrace today with PlayStation 3 and continue to demand.
Thank God.
There. When a gamer buys a PS4 disc, they have the rights to use that copy of the game. They can trade in the game at retail, sell it to another person, lend it to a friend, or keep it for...
Yes! No DRM. Awesome, man. Thank you so much. Yes. God, Sony wins E3. Oh, I know. I haven't seen Nintendo. I don't know yet. Nintendo could win this.
In addition, PlayStation 4 disc-based games don't need to be connected online to play.
Yeah! Yes! Oh my God, yes!
Or for any type of authentication.
Yes.
If you enjoy playing single-player games offline, PS4 won't require you to check in online periodically.
Yes. Oh, Sony, you are just an amazing company right now.
And it won't stop working if you haven't authenticated within 24 hours.
Yes. Yes. Oh my God, so many shots at Microsoft. This is just amazing.
Of course, the experience on PSN will be amazing. Our goal for PlayStation Network.
Oh God, those few hits. So many shots at
gaming.
Oh God.
A network that is tuned to your
preferences. That was freaking amazing.
It's immediate and intuitive, and delivers a breadth of entertainment offerings that is unmatched in the industry. In New York, we announced several new PSN capabilities that will be available day one on the PlayStation 4, such as the ability to play games that are being downloaded in the background.
Yes.
Cross-game voice chat, to transition to a friends network based on real-world friends to provide a more meaningful social.
And you can help them out in the game.
And the new share button to immediately upload live stream via Ustream.
Yes.
PlayStation Network also offers incredible value to our customers through PlayStation Plus.
Awesome.
And we're very focused on expanding the benefits of the service.
Cool. This is what I've come to see from PlayStation.
We've received lots of questions from our community over the last several months about whether the existing PlayStation Plus memberships will apply to PS4. I'm pleased to confirm that your PS Plus membership will carry over to PlayStation 4.
Awesome. Just really, really awesome.
So members will have access to all the benefits across PS3, Vita, and now PlayStation 4 for one price.
Yes.
In short, if you're a Plus member today, or
you're always
tomorrow,
a Plus member,
you're already set for PlayStation 4.
Yes.
For less than $5 a month, members will get discounted games, cloud saves, automatic game updates, early access to beta programs,
an
instant
collection.
Game collection, as well as the ability to fully immerse themselves in the incredible PS4 games with online multiplayer. And PS4 gamers that aren't PS Plus members will be able to enjoy the single-player games for free, and access to all of your media services won't require Plus.
Wait,
we've
what?
Added instant game collection to Plus last year, and it's been an incredible success. Plus membership has increased by more than 140%.
Do I have to pay for online
member
now?
Member satisfaction is currently at 95%. I'm happy to announce that when PS4 launches, PlayStation Plus members will get immediate free access to Drive Club PS Plus Edition as part of the Instant Gamers Collection.
Nice. That is awesome.
Drive Club PS Plus Edition is a huge AAA title that combines incredible fidelity and driving mechanics with innovative social integration. It's the perfect game for the Instant Game Collection because the social capabilities foster vibrant communities, and these experiences will now be shared with your closest friends who are Plus members.
Cool.
In addition to Drive Club PS Plus Edition, Plus members will get a new title every month for free, including Don't Starve, Outlast, and The Secret Ponchos.
Cool.
Three incredible titles that you just saw.
Nice.
The first year of PS4.
Supporting the indie crowd. That's amazing. Really glad, Sonny, you're not screwing this up.
As you heard us say tonight, PlayStation is all about games. Tonight, we've seen some exceptional examples from our worldwide studios teams and from partners around the world. However, we've saved something special for you. From the visionary partnership between Bungie, one of the best developers in the industry, and Activision, the company that built Call of Duty not just into the biggest game, but one of the biggest entertainment franchises in the world. It comes from an Epic Game Best Experience on PlayStation. These are two partners that haven't just made great games, they've each revolutionized first-person shooters over the last decade. I'm very proud to introduce the world gameplay premiere of Destiny.
Woohoo! Finally get some gameplay footage. Many years from now, this game just looks beautiful. A lot of these games are looking really good on this console. I'm really happy with Microsoft with how Sony's doing their console. It's just the most impressive thing I've ever seen. Oh god, it's four. Oh my god, it's a Covenant Elite. Very stylized too. It's nothing like how Halo was, or maybe it's a little bit like Halo, but it just looks like a really good game. I wonder if you can choose how you customize your character or how he looks or not. Oh, you're playing already.
And I'm going to meet up with some of my friends, and together, we're going to explore the wild frontier beyond that wall.
The Warlock class. Jeez, look at the rust on those cars. Look at the amount of decay and everything. That's something that's impressive. I mean, like, you got so much detail. Like, on the sign right up there, the freeway sign. Cities.
Hey, Jason Jones. How's it going?
So what are we doing, Joe?
Well, you and me, we're going to play through that wall. Unfortunately, looks like we got a man down. But we're going to keep on going. You ready? Come on. It's going to be great. There you go. You coming?
I'm coming.
I knew you'd make it. Jason Jones. Someday I knew you'd come right back through my door. All right, buddy. So you and me, we're going to go that way. Why don't you take point?
Oh, their demo's freezing up. No. Not during Destiny. We've been waiting to see gameplay footage of this for a while. Oh, like Spongy. Damn, look at all that. It's just so massive on a lot. It's just so massive.
How are we looking?
Looks clear.
Okay, I'm gonna go first.
I hope this isn't. Man, this might be the last thing they're showing. Which sucks, because I wanted to see more or something. I'm surprised Ubisoft hasn't shown anything for...
It's getting a little dark. I'm going to take out my ghost.
We always visit such cheerful places.
So the ghost acts as your flashlight. That's neat. Oh, he just... Oh, there's a little ghost thing found power.
They have overdone it. We've got trouble.
Ooh, look at this.
Coming back to you.
This game.
You're right. Yep.
Ooh. I'm loving that they've gone away from... They've stuck with their old Halo formula, but they're creating something completely new. These guys are called the Fallen. They look like an alien race of some sort. Like a repainted Magnum pistol. Works like one too. Headshot, too.
Hey, we got more guys down low.
Ooh. The large.
Yes!
Nice.
All right, let's mop them up.
I'm loving the vastness of the areas you fight in. It's something that's really nice looking. It gives you something really nice to look at. Ooh, shit, that guy's ripped.
No,
Rixis.
Jones!
Archon Slayer.
Hang tight!
Go save him.
All right, let's grab our loot.
Get all the epic loots.
The Thunder Lord.
The Thunder Lord. All praise the Thunder Lord.
Exotic. Heavy machine gun. Nice.
The top talent's my favorite, but you'll probably never get there.
Oh, yeah? What's up top? That's gonna be pretty sweet. Alright, let's see how she looks.
Ooh. Very nice.
Yep. That's big and blue and covered with lightning. Plug your ears. Oh, that's good. What'd you get?
Check this out. I need to be jealous of a sniper rifle.
Oh, I do like the long rifle. What's its name?
Shut up and get behind me.
What am I watching? A Call of Duty clan match or something? Or Jesus Christ. Like I'm really playing Halo multiplayer again. What's his name? Shut up and get behind me.
Looks like you guys could use a Titan.
Absolutely.
So what are we doing? And can I use
She looks like a space marine. Oh my god. What is that? Ooh, shit. What the fuck is that? Oh, wow. That thing is freaking huge.
Hey, guys. That doesn't look friendly.
Public event. Fallen Assault.
Yes, it's a public event.
There's another fire team. Let's go.
Right behind you.
Oh, that's right. I forgot Destiny's an MMO. Guy needs a revive. Should help him.
Hey, we got another dropship coming in. It's got a devil walker.
Seriously. Dude, that's like a seriously pissed off Tachikoma. Oh my god. Seriously, that's some Ghost in the Shell shit right there. I mean, look at that Devil Walker. It looks like a freaking Tachikoma. Except it's big, black, and red, and totally pissed off. Gotta blow it up. Standalone comic shit right here.
Here I go.
Oof. I wonder what loot they got out of that. Oh, beautiful. Sony does it again.
We barely survived the last. We must regain the offensive.
Look at those things.
Why is the city breathing down my neck?
Why don't you put that down so we can talk?
Out here in the wild, this is how we talk.
Hmm. These beautiful environments. It's just something that's nice. I hope this is coming to PC. Though I probably wouldn't be able to run it on this computer. There's just no way.
If you succeed, you will become legend. If you fail, this city will fall, and the last light of civilization will go out.
Destiny. 2014. Goddamn.
Thank you. I am happy to announce that we've established a long-term exclusive partnership with Bungie and Activision that will ensure PS4 evolves and grows with the incredible Destiny world over the years.
Awesome.
Just as exciting as the extraordinary games available across the PlayStation ecosystem is the introduction of our cloud-based strategy. A few months ago, David Perry from Gaikai discussed the vision behind integrating Gaikai's advanced cloud-based technology into the world of PlayStation.
I thought this was over.
Today, it's a Gaikai fan out there. Today, we'd like to put a little context around this advancement.
The Gaikai.
Over the past 20 years, PlayStation has created one of the largest gaming libraries in the world, a library that houses some of the most memorable experiences that gamers have ever encountered. The partnership between PlayStation and our vast library of games
keep dropping quarters.
Cloud-based technology is the next step in giving gamers an all-access experience that will dramatically change how, when, and where they play. I'm happy to announce that PlayStation's cloud gaming service will be available in 2014, beginning in the US. Our cloud service will provide PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 3 customers, followed by Vita, with immediate access to a catalog of critically acclaimed PS3 games.
Awesome.
These games will be streamed using Gaikai technology. What that means is amazing gameplay that is fast, and responsive. PlayStation's cloud service is a lofty ambition, but one that we expect to see evolve rapidly.
Console quality games anywhere.
As access to console quality content becomes more seamlessly accessible across a range of devices.
PlayStation Vita, phones, tablets, hopefully PC.
We have worked tirelessly to bring the PlayStation ecosystem centered around PlayStation 4
PC.
Together in ways that meet the demands of today's gamers. The world of console-based, handheld, and cloud-based technology is more expansive than ever before. We will continue to work with the best and brightest developers and media partners to create a portfolio of titles and entertainment that is simply unbeatable. And we'll continue to offer the best value on the market.
Awesome.
I'm very proud to announce that PlayStation 4 will be available at $399.
Woo! Yeah! That's a good price. That is a good price. Good job, Sony. PS4 wins E3. No, I keep telling myself that. I'm gonna wait for Nintendo tomorrow. Wow.
€399. And for the folks in my homeland, £349 sterling. In the US and Europe this holiday season.
Ooh.
It's a very compelling price that offers incredible
value.
That
is an incredible value
right there.
Given the
amount of entertainment PS4 will provide to gamers over the next decade and beyond. Is PlayStation the best place to play?
Yes.
Without a doubt.
Without a fucking doubt. Damn right.
The gaming landscape is changing with new business models and new ways to play.
Good job, Sony.
But at PlayStation, concepts like true consumer ownership and consumer trust are central to everything we do.
Yes. We trust Sony.
With each new platform, we do our very best to earn that trust, and we will continue to prove to you that we have the games, the entertainment, the value, and the innovation to give you the very best place to play. Thank you so much for being here. Good night.
There you have it, everybody. Sony's E3 media briefing with the PS4 at a staggering $399. That is definitely a step up from when they had their PS3, which launched at launch was $599. This is definitely a good price point to compete with Nintendo and Microsoft. Microsoft's being, with theirs being, $499. Nintendo being at $200, I believe. No, $249 and $299 right now for the Wii U. Alright guys, this was an incredible conference. We got Destiny, Final Fantasy 15, Kingdom Hearts 3, the big shocker of the show, Transistor, Mad Max, more Watch Dogs, and the Dark Sorcerer. This was such a great conference, and we hope to see more from Sony in the future. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching Gaming Center CX. This is Brian signing out.